Hi, my name is Eshmalamte. I believe you've heard of Google Translate before. So Google Translate allows you to translate one language to another, be it from French to English, English to French, and so on. I don't know in what case or in what situation that you might have used Google Translate, but in today's video, I'm going to share with you a real life situation that got me use Google Translate in a very unique way. So I'm actually in a car. This is a Toyota Vitz and it came from Japan. So you can imagine everything is in Japanese. And for one part or one important part of the car, which happens to be the radio, I was hoping it should be at least in English. But it also is in Japanese, and it's very difficult for me, or it's been very difficult for me to change the language to English. So then I thought, okay, how about try a couple of these apps out there to see if it could do something. I tried a couple of them, and then I came back to Google Translate. So let me just open Google Translate and show you a unique way you can use Google Translate to do some of these translation. So there's a feature as part of Google Translate, which is the live translate feature. So in this case, all you have to do is to download the language that you want to translate to the different language. So in this case, the language I would want to download is Japanese. Let's just try a different language. So let me see, maybe Bengali. So you just hit on the download button or icon, and then it goes ahead to, let me just download this. It goes ahead to download it. Since in my case, it's Japanese, I downloaded a Japanese language, which is at the very top. And then I come to the camera section. So you tap on the camera section, and then when you look at the very bottom, it has instant, translation. So what I'm going to do next is I'm just going to position this on the radio, and then it should be, let me just flip it in a landscape way. So I have positioned it on the radio, and as you can see, it's translating this. So let me just get a bit closer. Let me just get to the setting, because that is what is most important to me. So trying to see if it's going to, all right, good. So we have information, settings. So then I know there's a setting. So I tap on settings, and then I show it to the screen. So it looks at whatever is there, and then it gives me additional information about it. So this is what Google Translate is actually capable of. I never knew about this feature because, you know, I haven't been doing this translation. But when I found it out, I noticed it's actually very cool to have something like this. So in case you ever find yourself in such situation, you're able to use this particular feature to be able to do a live translation. Unfortunately, I have still not been able to figure out how to change the settings of this particular radio from Japan to English. But I don't know if there's anyone out there who will be able to assist me. I'll be very, very glad. I'm actually told it's beyond just the settings. There's some form of decoding that has to be done and the rest, and I haven't really had time to look through how to go about it. So if you're out there and you can actually assist me, I'll be very grateful to at least get this from Japanese to English. Well, I don't speak Japanese. Maybe I might learn someday, but unfortunately I don't speak now. So that is basically just about it for this video. So it's one useful feature I find about Google Translate, which I don't know if you've ever tried it, but let me know what your thoughts are, if you've tried it, or which other apps that you've tried that you find very cool, in the comment section. Once again, my name is Eshmalamte. Thank you very much for watching. In case you haven't subscribed to this channel, kindly go ahead and then subscribe, and then don't forget to hit on the bell so that anytime I have a new video, you get to see it. So I'll see you in the next one.